introducing first.
It's now time for our PPW Tag Team Championship match. Their return to the Phoenix Theater after a long absence, the Rock and Rodeo Express. Rex Calhoun, TMT. The question now becomes, in their return, can they take down the upstart champions from the Honor Society? Because ever since their big win in November, they have looked very, very good. Got their win against Money, Power, Respect in January. And Eliza Hammer, who had a huge 2022, cannot get enough of the fans here in the Phoenix Theater. Meanwhile, Sir Samurai, one of Eliza's mentors, very, very patiently waiting for his tag team partners to get back in. And good on Samurai, it is St. Patty's Day. Now, traditionally, when you wear a kilt, you don't wear anything under it. So, you gotta be careful with wardrobe malfunction if you're Samurai here. But the Rockin' Rodeo Express, who make their return here tonight, against the champs, making their second defense of the PPW Tag Team Championships. The two-time champ, Sir Samurai, Eliza Hammer, for the first time, the PPW Tag Title holder. Of course, Samurai had the tag team titles with Cal Jack before losing them to the Bad Boys last year. And of course, as Cal Jack decided to try and go after Boyce, the original plan, I think, was for Samurai and Scoot Robertson, who was, to be perfectly honest with you, someone who we thought was going to be challenging Boyce for the PPW title at some point. But then, unfortunately, Scoot got hurt. Now it's Eliza stepping in and not only filling in, but showing that as a tag team wrestler, the Hammer knows how to get it done. Now, as you said, the Rock and Rodeo Express have a little bit of an attitude to them. You think that they kind of have this lovable personality, and well, here you go. They have found some crutches. This is not a no DQ match, remember. If the Rock and Rodeo Express use those weapons, they are going to get disqualified. You hear him jawing with the fans. But meanwhile, the Honor Society just patiently waiting in the middle of the ring, and Corey, rightfully, is counting them out. As Calhoun breaks the count and takes the time on the outside to try and maybe psych out the champs. But as I mentioned, when it comes to the champs, Samurai has done more than his fair share of work in the ring. another NorCal Wrestling Hall of Famer. Almost 30 years, and you can see Hammer. And Samurai just waiting it out. Stereo leg trips. Stereo Boston Crabs. See Calhoun going for the ropes. And I think it is Calhoun and Samurai as the legal competitors in this match. This is where things are breaking down a little bit. Is TMT is wanting a timeout. It should be noted that timeouts never were a thing in professional wrestling, ever. Ever. The fact that they're still being called in 2023, it's like, read a rule book. See TMD trying to get inside Eliza Hammer's head. Instead, the tag to Rex Calhoun. Strutting around the outside of the ring. Moonshine, as he likes to call himself. Trying to howl the moon a little bit. Reversal of the Irish whip. And now Hammer going into enemy territory. Oh, swinging Calhoun right into his partner. Oh, and well, that's the only word I can say for that is inadvertent. But I have a feeling that regardless of the outcome of this match, they'll be talking about that one after. And the double hammer, the Eliza hammer, taking down Calhoun, and Calhoun smartly going to the eyes. And I say smartly only because that's really the only thing he could do at that point. His hammer was all over him. Whip to the corner. Now TMT sent in, but misses with the double team whip. Hammer, smartly. Well, suffice to say, the double team machinations of the Rock and Rodeo Express are not working well. I don't know what to say. One, two. And only two. I think the only thing I can say is love is love. That's all I can say. As the champs working over Moonshine Calhoun. And then TMT hit Hammer with the crutch. DDT by Moonshine. And the challengers trying to steal one here too. But Hammer out at two. Those crutches that were on the outside, knew it was only a matter of time before maybe they found their way in, but I don't think anyone expected them there. And now Hammer's in trouble as the challengers have one half of the champs on their side of the ring, and Hammer choked across the second rope as Samurai trying to give chase, and Calhoun just dropping all of his behind over the middle rope. Only two though, as Hammer able to roll out. Hammer trying to battle back, but Calhoun goes to the eyes. Snapmare, that chin lock. Staring down Samurai, making him look at his partner. You see Hammer trying to bite out of it, but Corey saw that immediately, and Hammer ended up eating a shot to the head for all of that. Now the tag into TNT. Maybe double Russian leg sweep here. Nicely done. Cover two, and only two is the challengers. Trying to keep things on their side of the ring. But Hammer, she's want to do, really holds her own as TMT with the lariat in response, but only two again. We've seen it, Eliza, in these matches, kind of sink or swim territory. She has swum, and she has swum very well. Now TMT going to the hair, which, you know, can't really do, and now might be looking to make Hammer humble. Yes, it is the camel clutch as he derisively takes the arm and makes Hammer wave to the fans at home. TMT, ever since that crutch shot, got Hammer down. Has asserted himself well in this match. And now the tag to Rex Calhoun. Calhoun goes to the eyes again. It seems like the strategy for the Rock and Rodeo Express is when Hammer makes a comeback, go to the eyes. That has been the status quo of this match for the challengers. Meanwhile, Samurai has been on the outside, not able to get in for almost 5 minutes now. Tag back in to TMD. To the second rope. Elbow right to the jawline. One, two, and only two. One of three championship matches tonight. Still to come, Midas Creed challenges Kenny Kay for the Cruiserweight title. And Breath of Threat challenges Cal Jack for the PPW title. But can the champs hold on here, or will the Rock and Rodeo Express in their return win? And going low is TMT. But Hammer doesn't have the equipment. STO, Hammer rolls over, needs a tag. It gets it, there's Samurai. For the first time in the match, illegal man. And he is the proverbial house of fire. But there's Calhoun with that crutch. Samurai could be going for goodbye sunshine. No, TMT goes low. And that time it worked. Wait, that's Jacob Fatu, the Samoan werewolf. The former PPW champ, and Samurai with the crutch goes low.
Rock and Rodeo Express, and still PPW Tag Team Champions.
And that was in the view. So Samurai, after the crutch shot, the low blow, the Rock and Rodeo Express, who brought those crutches into play, a taste of their own medicine. But then on top of that, Jacob Fatu comes out, makes himself known, stops it from happening. And as that happens, the Rock and Rodeo Express try to make their move, but it backfires. They win the match, but they do not win the championship. And another shot for TMT, and the champs retain. So I don't know if that's the right way that they wanted to win the titles, or retain the titles, but a win is a win. Thanks to the former PPW champ, perhaps This will get the Honor Society in the right frame of mind going forward in 2023. It's interesting, though, that Patu came out then. Why, of all people, was it Jacob Patu helping out the Honor Society? Maybe time will tell on that one. But for now, retaining